Right, so as the sun's out today, I fancied getting my elastic stretch, so I'm focusing on pole fishing. I've picked three key areas of my swim that I'm going to fish today. The first one is the long pole line. Now, we're still sort of in winter really, the water's really cold, the wind's bitterly cold, and the fish this winter have been in the deeper water, out the way, in the middle of the lake, so that's the obvious place to start fishing. As the session goes on though, the fish might spread out a little bit and start feeding a bit more confidently, especially as the sun starts hitting the water and warming it up. So the short pole line might be the place to go, sort of the last sort of 2 hours of the session really. And that's often a place where bigger fish can feed as well. So that's a great place to sort of end up the session as the fish are sort of moving around a bit more, acting a bit more confidently, as I hope they will this afternoon. That's going to be a great place to fish. Likewise, the margins. I've got a bit of room today, nice long margin. It's a nice depth down the edge as well. I've plumbed up my rig about 3 foot deep, which is a nice sort of depth as we come into spring. You don't want to be looking into sort of too shallow water really. You know, the water's still cold, it can be clear at times, so 3 foot's an ideal starting point. And if I am getting lots of liners, I can plumb up into shallower water if need be, or maybe even deeper water. But that line there, I think it's an ideal depth, and hopefully we'll get a few there later on in the session. So those are the three key areas I'm going to fish today. I'm going to run you through the rig I'm going to use on each line. So on all three rigs, I've got 11 hollow, which is perfect for small carp. Even if I hook a few bigger fish, that's going to be perfectly adequate. Main line, nice and durable, 017. It's not going to let you down. That's 017 power. I've got a 4x10 carp pellet float, which importantly has got a nice thick bristle. I'm going to be fishing long today. And there's a bit of a naughty side wind skim. I'm going to need to be able to see that float without it dragging under. So that's a nice thick tip, nice slim, so it's nice and sensitive as well. You might notice that it's a 4x10 rig in about 4 and a bit foot, which is quite light, you might think, but bites this time of year tend to be quite delicate. So a lighter float can sort of help with that and amplify them little dinks and lead to less miss bites. Shotting pattern's really simple. I've got a spread out bulk of 10s and I've got 3 10s towards hook and then a 6-inch hook length, low 13 power line to a size 18 GPM barbless hook. I've got a band on there at the minute because I intend to fish hard pellets. It's also worth noting I've got a small cab put on at the minute. May or may not fish that, I'll see how the session goes, but initially I'm just going to start the session by feeding say 5 pellets and go from there. If I get a few bites then I'll carry on. If I feel I need to loose feed then I will. On the other line is my short line. Again, same elastic, it's actually a different float this time. It's a 4x10 F1 maggot. It's got a 1.5mm hollow bristle. Because I'm looking down on it, nice and close in, I don't need that thick bristle, I'm going to see it just fine. So it's exactly the same rig as before, just a different bristle on the float really. Same shot in, same hook, exactly the same. Again, I could swap to meat later on in the session, but at the minute I'm going to start off with pellets and see how that goes. I've plumbed that line up, the bottom of the shelf, with a top kit plus 2 sections, a nice distance out, I can throw on that line. It's not too close that I'm going to spook the fish if I do hook one, and hopefully as I gain a bit more confidence they'll be feeding closer in and we get a few later on in the session. Final rig is a margin rig. like I said earlier, I've set my rig at 3 foot and I've plumbed up and found a nice little flat spot down the edge. On this particular peg, it's quite deep close in, which should be ideal, plenty of cover for the fish. Exactly the same as before. I've even got the same float as a longer line. Although, you know, it's 3 foot deep, I want a slightly heavier float in that depth of water, just in case I get a few line bites. Again, it's got a nice thick tip, so it's not going to drag under. At the minute, I've got it strung out, but if there's a lot of fish there, I can bulk it down, maybe a bulking one dropper. And again, exactly the same as before. At the minute, I've got 013 power line. If I hook a few bigger fish, I'm going to step up to 015. It's not a problem. So it's 6 inches of 013, and I've got a 16 at the minute GPM hook, slightly bigger. At the moment, I've got a little quick stop on there, and I intend to fish a nice cube of meat, a little target bait, maybe a grain of corn, and I can swap that, you know, for a spade end hook and fish maggots. We'll just see how the session goes. Bait choice today is really simple. I've got some hard pellets. I've opened up some 4 and 6 mil fin perfect feed pellets. Initially, I'm going to start off on a 6 mil, but if bites are a bit hard to come by and I'm missing a few bites, I might drop down to a 4 mil, see what their response is. But pellets, particularly hard pellets, are a great bait for commercial fisheries, especially in the spring. Like I said earlier, I'm probably going to start off by cad potting initially. Maybe 4 or 5 pellets, see if I can get a bite straight away, carry on doing that. And then later on in the session, I might pick up a catapult and try and draw fish into my peg. And pellets like this make a great noise on the water. So hopefully they're gonna attract fish into my peg and keep a few fish ticking over while I'm fishing that longer line. On the shorter line, again, I'm gonna start off by fishing those 6 mil pellets, see what happens, but I've also got the option to fish 6 mil meat. A great way to pick out bigger fish, especially on that shorter line. You can keep a bit of bait going in during the day, and later on in the session, hopefully a few bigger size fish might rock up. Lastly, I've got a few micro pellets. Today I've got some 2 mil krill and squid pellets, nice and smelly. The water's quite coloured, so hopefully that might help draw fish into my peg. I'm probably going to feed little balls of these for a cad pot, and then maybe fish a cube of meat on the hook. Nice visual bait over the top of it. Just like a method feeder, really. Nice little clump of bait, my hook bait over the top. Just fish for one bite at a time. I'm not going to pile loads of bait in like you would do in the summer. And they are quite a light bait and might waft them around a bit, but this time of year they tend to be a little bit more sort of slower. It's not like summer where they're rocking in the margins and wafting it all up. So hopefully these 2 mils are going to draw fish into my peg and going to be catching that sort of one fish at a time, really. So that's my bait. Let's see if we can catch a few fish. Right, so we're into the session now. I've had a few carp straight away, just by cad putting a few sixes like that. But to be honest, it wasn't really quite as good as I expected. So what I've done is I've picked up the catapult. I'm still cad putting a few 6mm just to try and make a little accurate area over my hook bait. But I'm also loose feeding a few over the top, particularly when I hook a fish. So I'm shipping out now. I've got a few pellets in the pot. Also what I'm doing is I'm putting them in from a height to make a bit of a noise. And then I'm lowering my rig slowly over the top, straight in amongst those pellets. I've got a nice strung out rig as well, so it's going to fall nice and slow. And if I do start getting a few fish, intercept it on the way down, then that rig's going to be perfect for that. So it's just sat there now. What I've done is I've filled my catapult with 4 or 5 pellets. And I'm just waiting for a bite. And when I do get one, I'm going to loose feed over the top. And if I haven't had a bite for a little while, I will just sort of ping a few pellets over the top, make a bit of a noise. There's actually a few bubbles coming up, so should be able to get 1 or 2 bites, I would have thought. There's a bite. So I've loose fed over the top just to try and draw a few fish in for my next chuck. Slowly bring this fish out of the peg. About 11 olos, nice and soft. Ship straight back without worrying about the hook pulling. So I'm straight on the puller bung now. I'm not going to worry about feeding more pellets because it is middle of winter and I don't want to pile too much into my peg. Feels like a slightly better fish, actually. So there we go, nice little chunky top of man and mirror. Small fish, but hopefully a few bigger fish will rock up. I've had quite a few fish on that long line. It's been really good, to be fair. What is noticeable is I can't keep plundering it. I catch sort of 4, 5, maybe 6 fish, and then it goes a little bit quiet, and then they come back again. So now what I'm doing is, before that happens, I drop in on this short line. I'm not expecting this line to go mad. I'm just expecting to try and catch a quick fish, and then what that allows me to do is rest that longer line and gain their confidence again. So now I'm fishing this short line, what I'm going to do is keep the long line ticking over by just pinging a few over the top like I'm doing now. Try and be accurate. Then hopefully we'll catch a quick fish here. And then by the time I go back on the longer line, hopefully there'll be a few fish waiting for me. There we go. So that was a nice positive bite. Now I've done that. Keep the swim ticking over by a few loose feed pellets. So after I land this fish, what I might do is have another quick look, see if I can catch another quick fish, and then I'll go on along the line. Just keep the fish ticking over, keeps your catch rate up, and then you're not plundering each line. I mean, you could probably get away with fishing one line in summer, but at the minute, if you, because the water's still cold, if you catch too many fish from one line, they're likely to back away from you. Typical tub of mirror carp there, nice and lively.
There we go.
So what I'm going to do now is try and catch one more fish off that short line. See if we can catch a quick fish. Then I'll go back on the longer line and hopefully there'll be a few fish waiting for me. It's worth mentioning, I've also been putting a few micro pellets down the edge, ready for later on in the session when hopefully a few fish turn up in the margins. So hopefully a few more fish on these two lines, and I'll be able to show you some edge fish as well. So there we go. I've had a couple fish in the edge and I've just gone in, changed my hook bait actually. I put a pink piece of meat on. It sort of matched the loose feed a little bit because there's a few red flecks in there, so I thought I'd try it. And I've hooked a better fish now, so. So it's worth bearing in mind later on in the session, these bigger fish do tend to feed in the edge. Looking for a bit of bait, starting to move around. It's always worth feeding the margins because you might catch a bigger fish like that. So there we go. It's probably about 8 pounds. Nice bonus fish. And I guess it's a nice way to top the session off. So there we go. There's a few springtime tips and tactics for you. Hopefully it'll help you catch more fish like this. Cheers.